हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग बेटा, हाउ आर यू? फाइन, ओके. तो टुडे लेट यू रिवाइज द थर्ड इंस्ट्रूमेंट एंड नेम ऑफ द इंस्ट्रूमेंट इज अ स्फेरोमीटर. स्फेरोमीटर, द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द स्फेरोमीटर लाइक ए माइक्रोमीटर स्क्रू. इट हैज अगेन अ पिच, सो वन रोटेशन, दैट इज डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल्ड बाय द स्क्रू इन वन कंप्लीट रोटेशन is called pitch distance. So today our aim is to find the radius of curvature of this convex surface. It is single side, one side convex, second side is concave. It's a part of big hollow sphere and we have only a small piece of that sphere. Even we can find the radius of that sphere using this instrument. Name is spherometer. That's why the name of the instrument is spherometer. So let me study first about the instrument. One scale here. The distance between two division of this main scale is called pitch distance and it is equal to 1 mm. We can say it is 0.1 centimeter. And here there is a circular scale. You can see the division, which is here 0th division, then 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 100. Matching with this vertical strip is called a matching division. Here there are 100 divisions on circular scale. So least count of this instrument is 0.1. Let me note down this reading. Here pitch distance is 0.1. Pitch distance is 0.1 centimeter. There are 100 divisions on circular scale. So pitch distance upon total number of divisions, that is least count, and least count is 0.001 centimeter. Now to find the formula to find the radius of curvature of this convex surface is R is equal to L square by 6H, L square by 6H minus h by 2, where L is a distance between two legs of the spherometer. So this instrument has three legs. So let me measure the distance between these two legs and these two legs and find the average distance. And height, height means let this is a suppose plane surface and this is convex surface. So we will find on plane surface and find out on convex surface. By finding these two values, we can find the radius of curvature. Let me perform the experiment. To find the distance between two legs and height of the convex surface by practically. This is instrument. Let me take the impression of the tips of the legs of the spherometer. Here, so this is a point mark. First, second and third. Let me draw a triangle using these three points and the distance is 4.2 centimeter. Similarly, the second side is also 4.2 centimeter and third is also 4.2 centimeter. So here it is a 4.2 centimeter, 4.2 centimeter and 4.2 centimeter. So distance between two legs is average is 4.2 centimeter. Now let me find the height of this convex surface. So we will note down the reading in two different positions, first on plane surface, then on convex surface. So let me observe the first reading initially. Okay, so first place the instrument on surface and see All the tips should be approached to the surface. It is not approaching, you will close by the instrument screw. When it approaches, it will stop rotating. At that time, you will note down it is an initial reading. An initial reading is from the upper side, which is equal to 80. This trip is matching with 80th division. 80th division. So reading is 80 means minus 20 centimeter. So minus 20 division, sorry. So its value is minus 0.020 centimeter is the initial reading. Let me find it is a initial. Let me find the final reading. For that, you will place the instrument on convex surface. Obviously, right now these tips are coplanar, but when you place on convex surface, it will becomes unbalanced. To make it in balanced position, you have to move the screw in upward direction by rotating the screw. So let me rotate it in anti-clockwise direction. So 0 to 0, one rotation is there. Still it is unbalanced. One complete rotation, it is a not balanced. Give one more complete rotation, it is two complete rotation, still it is not balanced. Give one more, okay. On third rotation, it becomes balanced. Again, all the three legs and fourth tip of the screw are approaching surface. Let me note down this reading. So two rotation and matching division is, it is 66 plus 66 division. Two rotation, its value is 0.2, and 66 division, that is 0.066. So total value is 0.266 centimeter is the final reading. Let me note down in formula. So formula is radius of curvature. Radius of curvature. R is equal to L square by 6H plus H by 2, where L is equal to distance between two legs, which is 4.2 the whole square dividing by 6 into 0.266 plus H by 2, 0.266 by 2. Let me calculate and let me find its answer. Okay, now let me substitute or note down the reading. The distance between two legs of the spherometer was 4.2 centimeter. Again 4.2 centimeter, 4.2 centimeter. The average distance between two legs is equal to 4.2 centimeter. Now, as we have noted, the initial reading was minus of n. It is 0.066. As the initial reading was the 0.66, final reading was 0.266. Sorry, initial reading was 20, so it will be right here 0.020. On adding this, you will get final answer is 0.286. Let me substitute the values in formula. Okay, now L is, that is 4.2 the whole square dividing by 6 into H is equal to 0.286 plus H by 2, 0.286 dividing by 2. The final answer is On solving, you will get answer. It is around 10.42 centimeter is the radius of curvature of the convex surface. So, अपने पास जो वॉच ग्लास था, it's a part of big holosphere and it was made from the sphere having the radius 10.4 centimeter. So, this is a special instrument to find the radius of curvature of a sphere. That's why the name of the instrument is spherometer. So, this is the revision. Okay, students. So, it may be the reading different from the our previous readings. So, this is just the revision for this. Note down this of that previous experiment, reading of this previous experiment and complete the journal beta. Bye. Have a nice day. Thank you very much.